Welcome to another episode of TechBytes. My name is Denis Molin, Principal Data Scientist at Teradata. In this episode of Analytics 123 series, I'm going to demonstrate how to visualize data in Vantage using Python and Jupyter Notebook. This video is part of our Analytics 123 TechBytes series, and if you have not seen other episodes in the series, I encourage you to watch them. Let me first start with a brief introduction to Teradata Analytics 123 strategy. Analytics 123 establishes a straightforward roadmap that ensures machine learning and AI projects live up to their promise and delivers real business value. Analytics 123 decouples the different elements of the analytics process into three stages. Stage 1 is efficient data preparation and feature engineering. Stage 2 gives data scientists the flexibility to use their preferred tool to create predictive models bringing value to the business. And stage 3, deploy those models to score live data. For more information on Teradata's Analytics 123 strategy and Vantage capabilities that support the strategy, I encourage you to watch other episodes in the series. In today's demonstration, you will see how to start with Analytics 123 in Python with Vantage. We will see how to connect to Vantage from a Jupyter notebook and how to make our first visualization to pave the way to feature engineering and data preparation. Now, let's proceed to the demo. In this session, we will learn how to create a bar plot in Python that displays the result of an aggregation performed within Vantage. In this tutorial, the detailed data are located in a table in Vantage. To access the data, we first need to connect to Vantage, and we will use the Teradata ML package for that. This package is freely available on pypy.org. As shown here, we specify the host name, the username, the password, and the log mechanism, here LDAP. Then we can create the context using the create context method provided by the Teradata ML package. Great! The connection between the notebook environment and Vantage is established. Now we can connect to our data. For this, we need the name of the database that contains our table. For convenience, we store the database name in a variable, myDatabaseName. Then we need the name of the table that contains our data. Again, for convenience, we store this name in a variable, myTable. We are ready to connect to our data by creating a Teradata DataFrame object. Let's call this object myData. Let's have a look at our data now by typing data and executing the cell. A sample of few rows are displayed so that we can see that our table contains three columns named travel ID, events, and date time. These data deal with the events occurring during train travels. What we want to learn from this data is the frequency of these events and visualize the frequencies by event with a bar plot. But first, we have to compute the frequency of each event. This computation is called an aggregation. So how do we compute an aggregate in Python on data that are in Vantage? Actually, it is super easy when you know how to do it in Python with Pandas. With the Teradata data frame, it is exactly the same syntax than in Pandas. MyData.groupByEvents.aggregateCount. The difference with Pandas is that the computations are not performed within our client, here our Jupyter notebook, which would have required to download the data first. Instead, the computation is executed in the database, leveraging the computation power and the parallelism of Vantage. So let's run the cell and inspect the output. Again, we only see the first rows of the results for inspection only. We see our events column followed by the count results. In order to assess the size of the total result, let's use the shape command, like we would have done using a Pandas data frame. Now we know the result has 14 rows. It is small enough to safely download this data into a local Pandas data frame that will be used later on for visualization. To convert a Teradata data frame onto a Pandas data frame, it is super easy. Simply use the toPandas method of the Teradata data frame. It will return you a Pandas data frame. Now we can display all the results in a more familiar way. And it is time now for visualization. Let's store first our results in a Pandas data frame we named DFLocal. For the exercise, we import the famous matplotlib package. Now we have everything to make our plot, as usual, by using the Pandas package. And here we go. We can visualize a horizontal bar plot that shows how frequent our events are in our dataset. Congratulations! Now you know how to make visualization in Python using Vantage. This concludes this episode of TechBytes. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.